You're watching Tag TV. You're watching Tag TV.
Hello viewers, I'm your host Uzma Jafri with another episode of South Asia Focus. Let's begin the show with Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi's visit to the United States and his extensive formal and informal meetings with US President Donald Trump. While the principal aim of Modi's visit was to address the United Nations General Assembly, his other engagements reiterated Indian commitment of further bolstering the Indo-US ties that are already moving north from a significant period of time. A report.
In an event that was dubbed a carnival by many, tens of thousands of Indo-Americans packed into Houston Stadium to join Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi and US President Donald Trump. Experts say the location of the event was deliberately chosen as both leaders who have been working extensively to gain for their own national interests wanted to benefit from it. Houston is a rare Democratic stronghold in Republican-dominated Texas and serves as the economic anchor of a state that will be critical to Trump's 2020 re-election bid. Polls show tepid support by Indian American voters, some 75% of whom voted for his Democratic rival Hillary Clinton in 2016. Indian Prime Minister, who is seeking economic benefits for India, said that he trusted the US leadership.
When I met him for the first time, he said to me, India has a true friend in White House.
President Donald Trump, who reassured India, announced that the two countries will sign some major economic and defense deals in coming future.
We're looking forward to concluding several new defense deals very soon. There are a lot of them in the works. Here in America, we're creating the United States Space Force, and we're working closely with India to enhance space cooperation. In November, the United States and India will demonstrate a dramatic progress of our defense relationship, holding the first ever tri-service military exercise between our nations. It's called Tiger Triumph. Good name. It's a good name.
US-India trade relations have been fraught. Trump has repeatedly complained about India's high tariff rates, including a 50% tariff on Harley-Davidson motorcycles. However, the bonhomie between the two has seemingly sorted out the differences, and a delightful news could soon be out.
My understanding is that we expect it to be a fair and reasonable deal. We have laid out our requirements in that regard, so has the US side. It is now a matter of negotiating between the two sides on individual issues to ensure that at the end of the day, our requirement of access to the US markets for Indian companies and exporters to continue to do so, as well as to do so in new products, is secured. And at the same time, we also address some of the US side's concerns regarding what they consider to be a trade deficit.
The United States has also taken issue with India's new investment rules on e-commerce that limit how companies like Amazon.com and Walmart-backed Flipkart can do business in a rapidly growing online market set to touch $200 billion US dollars by 2027. Experts have time and again said that India and US are in a mutual need of each other, and the diplomatic channels of both countries working swiftly have also suggested similar tones in recent times.
Pakistan has been running pillar to post to forge a support for its false narrative on Kashmir. But to its disappointment, no major power, not even an Islamic country for that matter, has believed or backed it. The extensive efforts of Kashmiri people seem to have paid off, as everybody knows about the grim human rights situation in illegally occupied POK. While its desperate attempt of bringing a resolution on Kashmir fell flat in UNHRC after it failed to gather support from member countries, it received a similar rebuff at the United Nations General Assembly as well. It is in welfare of Pakistan now that it spots the writing on the wall, as ignoring it would tantamount inviting more troubles and only troubles. A report.
Pakistan is a global pariah. It has not been announced officially, but the actions of international community and various countries of late have suggested their growing disregard for this terror-breeding territory. While everybody was aware of its reputation in South Asia, the global community rebuff has now put a stamp on its isolation. Ever since India extended all rights and privileges to people in Kashmir by abrogating decades-old articles, a desperate and delusional Pakistan reached out to everybody it could forge an alliance against India, but nobody came in support. Rattled by such developments, it attempted to bring a resolution against India in the United Nations, but failed to gather even minimum support to move the proposal. POK activists who were present during the UNHRC session said that Pakistan has lost all support because people are now aware of the truth. They said no Kashmiri ever in his life wanted to be a part of Pakistan, and what people see on social media and news was just a part of propagandist exercise hatched and controlled in Islamabad.
Srinagar mein dikhate hain Pakistan mein television ke upar ke Srinagar mein julus nikal raha hai. 2000 aadmi ka julus hoga. Us 2000 aadmi ke julus mein do Pakistan ke jhande hain. Wo kahan se aaye jhande Pakistan? Hame pata hai na kahan se aaye. Wo bheje jate hain na jhande. Jis bag suitcase mein hand grenade, Kalashnikov aur ammunition jata hai, वो पाकिस्तान के झंडे में लपेट के भेजा जाता है ना, तो उधर से वो ग्रेनेड चलता है और जुलूस में जो उनका झंडा चलता है.
Today's situation of POK is that radicals have multiplied in number owing to a constant man and material support provided to them by Islamabad. The indigenous people are systematically targeted. Rights for them exist on paper, but they cannot even turn their heads without permission. Their dissent and dissatisfaction is muzzled with highest degree of force. When in POK, Prime Minister and his cabinet speak volumes about standing for the rights of Kashmiris, but their tone and tenor change when they speak in their own parliament. Kashmiri activists, however, say that they were always aware of this duplicitous character of Pakistan. It always wanted to exploit their land and suppress the locals.
इसने वहाँ असम्बली में पार्लियामेंट में शाह महमूद कुरैशी ने खुद नारे लगाए कश्मीर बनेगा पाकिस्तान. ये नारा लगाते ही उसने अपने ही कॉज को डिफीट कर दिया. यानी आप यूएन रेजोल्यूशन जो है उसके मुताबिक आप एक तरफ कहते हैं कश्मीरियों को खुद मुख्तारी होनी चाहिए, आज़ादी होनी चाहिए, और आप खुद ये कह रहे हैं कि हाँ खुद मुख्तारी तो देंगे लेकिन ज़मीन हमारी होगी. ये कौन सी खुद मुख्तारी है? तो ये सब जो है ये एक प्रॉपरली प्लान्ड है. इसके पीछे जो है वो भारत के जो एक इंडस्ट्रियल उभार आ रहा है भारत में, जो 5 ट्रिलियन की इकोनॉमी बनाने जा रहे हैं, इंडिया की जो नेशनल बुर्जुआजी है उसको सैबोटाज करने के लिए चाइना पाकिस्तान उसका सैटेलाइट स्टेट है इस वक्त. उसकी अमेरिका को छोड़ के अब पाकिस्तान चाइना का इत्तेहादी बन गया है.
पाकिस्तान हैज बीन प्लंडरिंग द रीजन फॉर मोर देन 7 decades. It has constructed only those projects and facilities that are profitable to it. It has been completely indifferent to the inconvenience and plights of the people during the course of achieving its objectives. In fact, a brute force has been employed to crush the voices that even uttered anything against the colonial establishment. Activists say that people of the region hate Pakistani army generals, which has held a great sway in everyday discourse.
1960 में जब ये डैम बना, मंगला डैम जिसको कहते हैं, तो हमारा गांव, हमारी कब्रें, हमारे स्कूल, हमारी मस्जिद, वहाँ मंदिर भी थे, सारा कुछ जो है गुरुद्वारा सब पानी के अंदर चला गया, डूब गया. और हम महाजर तो थे ही, हम महाजर दर महाजर हो गए. आज़ाद कश्मीर जिसको ये कहते हैं, मुझे ज़मीन दो ना, मैं घर बनाऊँ। मेरा तुमने डुबो दिया, मेरा घर डुबो दिया, मेरा गांव डुबो दिया, मेरे अबाजदाद की कब्रें डुबो दी। जब डैम का पानी उतरता है तो हज़ारों की तादाद में लोग डैम के किनारे खड़े होकर बोलते हैं, वो हमारा मकान था, वो हमारा बाप दादा की कब्र थी, वो ये था, वो था। फिर उन्होंने डैम बनाया तो उन्होंने वादा किया था कि आपको बिजली फ्री देंगे। हमारी ज़रूरत है 300 मेगावाट की, पूरे आज़ाद कश्मीर की। उन्होंने कहा था आपको बिजली फ्री देंगे, लेकिन 5 रुपये फी यूनिट, 6 रुपये फी यूनिट के हिसाब से हम बिजली खरीदते हैं उनसे, और 1400 मेगावाट वहाँ से पैदा होती है। फिर ये हर वक्त ये कहते हैं कि इंडिया पानी बंद कर देगा, इंडिया पानी बंद कर, एक खौफ की इन्होंने फ़ज़ा वहाँ कायम करके उनको ये शो किया हुआ है कि पाकिस्तान आर्मी आपका दिफा करने के लिए आ रही है। लेकिन पाकिस्तान आर्मी ऑन द रिकॉर्ड है कि वहाँ पे मकामी लोगों में इतनी शदीद नफरत है पाकिस्तानी आर्मी के ख़िलाफ़, क्योंकि कोई भी आर्मी एक कलोनियल आर्मी की प्रेजेंस को एक्सेप्ट नहीं करे।
Times, however, are seemingly changing, and they are changing fast. After more than 7 decades of misrule, it seems Pakistan can no more suppress the people of POK, as they have vowed to go to any extent to break the shackles of tyranny and colonialism. Its testimony manifested in a recent political event, where hundreds of locals chanted anti-Pakistan slogans and demanded freedom in rally conducted by Pakistani Prime Minister in the illegally occupied town of Muzaffarabad.
Moving on to Afghanistan, which is ready to choose its next president. 4th presidential elections since the ouster of the Taliban rule in the country come at the heels of the collapse of months-long peace talks between the insurgents and the United States. While the candidates, mainly incumbent President Ashraf Ghani and Chief Executive Abdullah Abdullah, speak of strengthening the democratic institutions of the country, the common people across the country have a single demand of peace. Despite Taliban's upped offensive, people are excited to participate in the elections, which they expect are going to be fair and transparent.
$9.6 million registered voters of Afghanistan are sealing the fate of over a dozen candidates in fray for presidential elections on 28 September. The democratic exercise that has already been marred by upped offensive of the Taliban will finally be materializing after months of delay. Though election officials say preparations are well in hand, security worries could lead many to stay at home, potentially undermining the legitimacy of the eventual winner if turnout is too low. The Taliban have made no secret of their aim of disrupting the election when President Ashraf Ghani will be bidding for a second 5-year term.
Asghar Mehrzade hastam, rais muassese sulh o sabk azad va club Drop and Write. Dar mavard intekhabat peshroi omedvar hastam ke yak intekhabat shaffaf bargozar shava ta ke yak kase dar ras jomhur qarar begire va bitane kishvar az halat feili yani az halat bohran berun bekashe va bitane basalh o arami
The 70-year-old US-trained former World Bank official Ashraf Ghani came to power in 2014 after winning a bitterly disputed election marked by accusations of cheating. He is widely expected to win again. Having taken office as most foreign troops were leaving, with a much reduced NATO alliance mission focused mainly on training local forces, his government has struggled to combat a growing Taliban insurgency.
Mohammad Rafi Sultanism, 20 sala az betim Kabul ske dar Kabul va nazaram darbare intekhabat yest ke ham abrim ba pay sandokhay ray va ba rais jamhur ainde ma ray betim va khohan yestem ke rais jamhur ainde ma yak shakhs khub bashad ta betane ba varzishkaran mardom va kishwar ma khidmat konad.
Despite the security problems, many Afghans appreciate Ghani's anti-corruption policies, opening of economic corridors with regional powers, and appointing of young and educated Afghans in top government positions.
اسم من محمد اشرف فرزند حاجی بیولای آهنگر 32 ساله هستم مدت 20 سال میشه کار آهنگری میکنم آمدیم در مورد انتخابات نگاه میخواهیم که یک انتخابات خوب بشوری داشته باشیم و از تمام مردم خود تقاضا میکنیم که یک شخص بسیار نیک مسلمان عادل رای بتن که انتخاب شود بخیر
Ghani is up against a crowded field of 15 candidates, including long-term rival Abdullah Abdullah, now serving as the country's chief executive as a legacy of the bitterly disputed 2014 election. One of the main contenders in Gulbuddin Himakhtiar, a former warlord whose fighters are accused of killing thousands in Kabul during the 90s civil war. Tens of thousands of soldiers, police and civilians have been killed in the last 5 years, leaving Afghans weary of endless violence and widespread corruption in public life.
Securing numero uno position in anything and everything even remotely evil or criminal is now a characteristic of Pakistan. It is not just the neighbors or the international community, but people inside its boundaries are also unsafe from the criminals it is breeding on everyday basis. In a horrific incident which has the potential of shaking conscience of any sane brain, an 8-year-old boy was molested, killed and dumped at a secluded place in the Kasur district of Punjab. If you're feeling disgusted, then you must know that this wasn't the first and exclusive case. With an increased rate of 11%, around 4,000 cases of child abuse were reported in 2018 alone.
Fear and anger have gripped Kasur district of the Punjab province of Pakistan, as history made a close replica of itself when the bodies of three missing children were found in a district which has seen numerous cases of child abuse and abductions in recent years. Police claims to have significant progress in the suspected murders and sexual assaults of the boys. The local, however, accused them of negligence. The body of Mohammed Faizan had been found the previous week, a day after he went missing. 8-year-old Faizan had failed to return home with his brother when the two went to nearby shops to buy snacks. His body and the remains of two more boys were later found on the deserted section of an industrial estate. She demands barbaric death penalty for the perpetrators so that it creates deterrence.
ਇਥੇ ਅੱਡੇ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਚੌਂਕ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਖੰਭਾ ਲਗਾ ਕਰ ਉਸ ਕੋ ਨਾਲ ਲਟਕਾਇਆ ਜਾ ਰਵੇ ਹੱਥ ਮੇ ਟੋਕਾ ਹੋਵੇ ਫੜ ਕੇ ਛੋਟੇ ਛੋਟੇ ਕੁਤਰੇ ਹੁੰਦੇ ਕਰਾ ਕਰਕੇ ਫਿਰ ਉਸ ਕੋ ਫਾਂਸੀ ਦੇ ਦਿਓ ਫਾਂਸੀ ਦੇ ਕੇ ਫਿਰ ਨੀਚੇ ਉਤਾਰ ਕਰ ਉਹਦੇ ਤੇ ਦਵਾਈ ਫੈਂਕੀ ਜਾਏ ਫਿਰ ਉਹਨੂੰ ਕਿਸੇ ਚੀਜ਼ 'ਚ ਬੰਦ ਕੀਤਾ ਜਾਏ ਬੰਦ ਕਰਕੇ ਉਹਨੂੰ ਲਪੇਟ ਕੇ ਰੱਖ ਦਿਓ ਜਦੋਂ ਕੀੜੇ ਚੱਲ ਜਾਣ ਜਦੋਂ ਬਿੱਛੂ ਬਣ ਜਾਣ ਸੱਪ ਠੂਮੇ ਬਣ ਜਾਣ ਫਿਰ ਉਹਦਾ ਤੇ ਅੱਗ ਪਾ ਕੇ ਆਦਮੀ ਅੱਗ ਲਾ ਤਜਾਬ ਸੱਟ ਕੇ ਅੱਗ ਲਾ ਦੇਣੀ ਫਿਰ ਉਸਕੀ ਸਵਾਹ ਬਣ ਜਾਣੀ ਹੈਗੀ ਸਵਾਹ ਵੀ ਹਵਾ ਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਉਡਾ ਕੇ ਤੇ ਫਿਰ ਵੀ ਮੈਨੂੰ ਸਬਰ ਨਹੀਂ ਆਉਣਾ
ਲੋਕਲ ਮੀਡੀਆ ਰਿਪੋਰਟਡ 3 ਅਦਰ ਚਿਲਡਰਨ ਫਰੋਮ ਦ ਏਰੀਆ ਹੈਵ ਬੀਨ ਮਿਸਿੰਗ ਸਿੰਸ ਦ ਮਿਡਲ ਆਫ ਦ ਈਅਰ ਐਂਡ ਅਨਦਰ ਚਾਈਲਡ ਹੈਡ ਡਿਸਅਪੀਅਰਡ ਲਾਸਟ ਵੀਕ ਆਫਟਰ ਦ ਬੋਡੀਜ਼ ਵਰ ਫਾਊਂਡ Last year, the body of a 7-year-old girl was found in a garbage dumpster, which police said was the 12th incident of a girl being abducted, raped and killed in the district in a year and sparked violent protests. A man was convicted of the murder and executed.
Uski report jab thane mein aayi thi, wo bacche ko dhoondte, ye jo aaj kiya hai police ne, wo pehle karte. ये तीन बच्चे बाद में आज ना होते ये कारी साहब का बच्चा ना की जान जाती वो जाते हैं हमारे मसाए के बच्चे थाने में वो कहते हैं आपने बच्चों को गाज में झगड़ा किया होगा, कोई वजह होगी जो बच्चा आपका भाग गया है।
Hundreds more protested last week, blocking off streets and damaging shops. Families in the area are fearful of the welfare and safety of their children. Police are continuing to investigate the suspected murders and disappearances and are also looking into the possibility of a serial killer. Interviews with children, families, organizations and officials in Kasur over the time have revealed that many working children, particularly boys, are expected to indulge in sexual activity with employers, peers and acquaintances, often in return for work or accommodation. Victims are often threatened to keep silent and the mechanism of fear almost always works.
I think this child abuse is a huge, huge challenge, not just in Kasur, but these cases are coming a lot in and being reported in Punjab on a daily basis. I myself deal with child abuse cases and I take action on them, so I'm also watching this since the last 6 months since I've joined. I think this is some psychopath and some serial killer involved in these cases, and it's about, you know, reshaping the society as a whole, which cannot be done overnight. It will take time.
In 2015, a long-running child pornography ring was uncovered after video footage of an estimated 300 children being sexually abused came to light in Hussain Khanwala village. The perpetrators were found to be young men in their 20s and 30s.
Moving on. The mega season of Hindu festivals in India is about to commence with Durga Puja, and people across the country are all geared up. While the number of celebrations involved and their intricacies are wide, it is the idols of deity Durga which hold the maximum significance. Weeks before the festival, hundreds of artisans start making the idols. Today, we have brought for you the preparation for the festival which has idol making as its chief component. Have a look.
As Durga Puja draws closer, the idol makers and artisans are giving their sweat and blood to carve out the most realistic looking idols in Assam's Guwahati city. Idol making had always been an age-old tradition for the people of states of Assam, Tripura and Kolkata, especially during Durga Puja. Durga Puja or Durgotsav is an annual Hindu festival which reveres and pays obeisance to Goddess Durga and is mostly celebrated in West Bengal, Assam, Bihar, Tripura and Odisha.
इस बार स्पेशल 8 पीस ही बनाया है, 6 पीस आपका बाहर में चला गया, 2 पीस यहां पे है, टोटल 35 मूर्ति है। इसमें स्पेशल आपका चोट का वो है, कपड़ा है जो आर्ट में आता है, उस टाइप का है और एक नॉर्मल टाइप का है जो अगला कपड़ा पहनेगा। मार्केट दिन-दिन पूजा बढ़ रहा है। हां, हम लोग का तो सब कारीगर कुछ केसबीआर से है, कुछ कलकत्ता से है।
Efficiency, skills and hard work are all one needs to shape idols which will come to life and be witness to countless tears, smiles, appreciations and laughter. All thanks to the unique sculpting skills of the artisans who are busy giving the last touch. The idol makers are toiling hard, breathing life into these effigies by making them into beautiful idols from clay and mud ahead of the festival. Some are busy making idols out of clay, while some are busy shaping eco-friendly idols using husk. The making of the idol is perhaps more interesting as a celebration, and it is also an opportunity for the artisans to make good money out of it.
Murti is baar mota moti apka 30 se 35 piece hoga, aur कंप्लीट तो पूजा से पहले पंचमी का दिन में सब ले जाएगा मूर्ति। स्पेशल तो अभी तक तो हुआ नहीं है, आपका कहाँ फिनिशिंग में स्पेशल आएगा। मेरा यहाँ कम से कम 10 आदमी काम कर रहा है।
दिन है काम चल रहा है?
दिन है रात 2-3 बजे तक चलता है, सुबह 7 बजे से।
Wherein the markets are flooded with Chinese products, the handmade idols are making their way in the global markets, which is a tribute to the local artisans. This year, Durga Puja is all set to commence on 28th September and end on the 8th of October. It's a festival that marks the triumph of good over evil.
The main event of Durga Puja will take place from October 4 to October 7, followed by the grand immersion of Durga idols on October 8. With that, we come to the end of this week's episode. See you next week. Goodbye and take care.